There are now 47,327 confirmed cases, including 2,617 deaths. To date, labs across Canada have tested over 717,000 people, with about 7% of these testing positive. Another week is upon us, and I know that we're all weary, and the longer days and warmer weather are making us all feeling increasingly antsy. In fact, these past weeks have made the words of millions of kids ring true as they shout from the back seat, "Are we there yet?" I think I speak for all of us when I say we have never felt more like that kid, though I'm sorry to say no, not quite yet, and though we are getting closer all the time, we can't let go of the wheel yet. My reflection this past weekend was very much on the bigger picture. So when I think about where we are right now, with outbreaks in vulnerable settings and underserved populations driving the epidemiology of COVID-19, I am reminded of the critical importance of addressing inequities. This pandemic has exposed the fragility of some of our populations, especially those living in long-term care homes, group housing, those experiencing homelessness, or vulnerable Indigenous communities. It has also highlighted the basic subsistence challenges of those working in our essential services who cannot self-isolate, such as our healthcare workers and those growing, delivering, and stocking our food, medicines, and other vital supplies. The bad bugs are not going away. So if we are to end the tragedy of increased disease and death rates in vulnerable populations, we need to make things right now. This is not just someone else's problem or someone else's sorrow. Inequities touch us all. They affect the health and social well-being of all Canadians, just as they diminish our humanity. That means we need to look beyond the health system to the expanse of the public health, social, cultural, and economic fabric of our society. And this approach needs to be woven into both our cautious descent down the epidemic curve, as well as going forward to living with COVID-19. To put this virus in a corner where we manage it and not the other way around, we need to adapt our daily lives to the need for hand washing, physical distancing, and other control measures. And at the same time, we need to build protective supports into our social fabric to provide long-term protection against future waves of COVID-19 and future pandemics of emerging disease. Last night, Canadian luminaries from the worlds of music, sport, science, advocacy, television, and cinema brought us together virtually through the Stronger Together special. In addition to being extremely emotional and entertaining, it raised much-needed funds for food banks across Canada and allowed us to pay tribute to the heroic efforts of our frontline workers during this crisis. Stronger together is how we are going to get through this. Thank you.